Hi, this is Jevan Kharod, a production chemical engineer by profession. Now going to continue. Start confined space entry, part C. Up till now, what we have seen or learned is scope and its applications, definitions, general requirement, permit required for confined space entry, entry permit, training, duty of authorized entrant, duty of attendant, rescue and emergency services, and employee participation. Right? Now we further. Appendix A, a permit required, confined space, decision, flowchart. Appendix B, procedure for atmospheric testing. Appendix C, example, the permit required, confined space program. Appendix D, confined space entry checklist. Appendix E, the sewer system entry. And Appendix F, rescue team or rescue services evaluation criteria. Right? Now attendant, individual stranded outside one or more permit space who monitor, authorize entrant and perform all attendant duty assigned employer permit space program attendant duty no hazard that may be faced during entry aware possible behavior effect the hazard exposure in authorized entrant the continuous maintain accurate count the authorized entrant and remain outside permit space during entry operation until revealed by another attendant. Okay. Duty of attendant. Communicate with authorized entrant. Monitor activity inside and outside space. Swimmer and rescue and other emergency services. Perform non-entry rescue specified employee rescue procedure. Perform no duty that might interfere with primary duty to monitor and protect authorized entrant and evacuation of the alarm executed. A definition, surrounding and effective occupied person by liquid or finally divided solid substance that can be aspirated to cause death by filling or plugging respiratory to cause, can exert enough force of an body to cause death, strangulation, the contraction or crushing, entry, action by which person passes through the opening in the permit required, confined space, entry include ensuring work, activity space and is considered have occurred as soon as the any part of entered body break plan of the opening in space. Entry supervisor person, such employer, foreman, crew, chief responsible for determine expectable entry condition. They are present a permit space where entry is planned or authorized entry and overseeing the entry operation and termination entry. Note, entry supervisor may serve attendant or authorized entry as long as person trained, evacuated as required for each role filled. Non-hazard may be faced during entry including information, mode sign or symptom and consequences of the exposure. Briefly, by checking that appropriate enclosure have been made, the permit all test specified permit have been conducted and all procedure, equipment, specific permit are in place, the endorsing permit, they are in place, verify that cause rescue services available and means summonizing they are operable, right? Remove unauthorized individual who enter, attempt to enter permit space during entry operation, determine whenever responsibility for permit space entry operation transfer at the interval hazard and operation performed by space entry opening remain consistent with the term of entry permit and accessible the entry condition they are maintained. Hazard atmosphere. The atmosphere that may expose employee to risk of death, incapacitation of the impatient of ability to self-rescue, the escape from the permit space injury or acute illness from one or more following cause, the flammable gas, vapor or mist in excess of 10% lower explosive limit, airborne combustible dust, concentration meet exit the area. Isolation. The process which permit space is removed from the surface and completely protected against rise of the energy and material in the space, such means as blanketing or blinding. Now, PRC has written plant outline. It is introduction of company policy, definition, identification of the confined space, notification and warning, hazard identification, equipment or entry and rescue, evaluation of the confined space, permit, authorized entrant, authorized attendant, entry supervisor, entry procedure, communication procedure, rescue procedure, closure procedure, coordination work with contractor, program review and update and training requirement, the documentation. Okay. Now entry permit. The permit space to be entered, the purpose of entry, the date and authorized duration of the permit, authorized entrant, the authorized attendant, name and signature of the entry supervisor, hazard of permit space to be entered, the isolation of hazard, control measure, expectable entry condition, rescue of the initial and periodic atmosphere monitoring, rescue and emergency services. The communication procedure, equipment required for entry and rescue operation, other necessary information, and realize the permit, all the hazard found, regular workspace, also confined space. Poor air quality. There may be insufficient amount of oxygen for worker to breathe. The atmosphere might contain a poisonous substance that could make worker ill or even cause worker lose consciousness. Natural ventilation alone while often not sufficient maintain breathable quality of the air. Hazard from expectorant. Simple expectorant gases which can become concentrated, they displace air normally 21%, low oxygen level 19.5, can cause symptoms such as rapid breathing, rapid heart rate, circumstances, emotional upset and fatigue. A less oxygen become available, nausea and vomiting, collapse the convolution, coma and death can occur, unconsciousness death. Then take full result with following exposure, simple excipient, argon, nitrogen or carbon monoxide. Chemical exposure due to skin contact and injection as well as inhalation of bad air. Fire hazard. There may explosive flammable atmosphere due to flammable liquid gases and combustible dust while process hazard, noise, heat, cold radiator, vibration, clerical and inadequate lighting, safety hazard such as moving part of the equipment, structural hazard, engulfment, the silo and tolls, vehicular and pedestrian trackle, the shifting and collapse, the bulk material, barrier failure, resulting flood and release, the free flowing solid and liquid, visibility, biological hazard, versus the bacterial form, the meter sludge and fungi mold. Walk in confined space hazard, the confined space, the entrance and exit, the confined space, might not allow the worker to get out of the time, should there are allocate the collapse free flowing solid, self rescue by worker is more difficult, rescue victim is more difficult, the in configuration, confined space, often not allowed, easy movement, people or equipment with it, natural ventilation alone, while often not be sufficient to maintain breathable quality of air, interior configuration, confined space, does not allow easy movement of air within it, and work activity may introduce hazards not present initially. Okay guys, this is up to part C. Next session, we conducted part D of the confined space. Till then, enjoy your day. Bye.